In this episode, we are leaving Gran Canaria to sail across to Cape Verde, a distance of 860 nautical miles. This is the moment we've all been waiting for, the start of the Atlantic crossing. The boat was prepared and in better shape than ever. The crew was ready, now increased by one person, Jan, Paul's brother. We bought, cooked and stored food for at least 30 days. We also got the recommendation to buy as much as possible of tomato cans, cereal, toilet paper, olive oil, beer and wine, since it's a lot cheaper here than in the Caribbean.
Vi vill egentligen ha en stor bananstock och hänga bak på Targabågen, men så kommer vi ju ha 100 bananer på bågarna samtidigt.
Här har vi chicken, köttfärs, lasagne bolognese färdigt, ifall vi blir körsjuka. Lunch imorgon, pizza.
Our new vacuum machine was used a lot, mainly for food, but also for clothes that we didn't need anymore. It's a big thing for us to put away woolen underwear, since we have lived with them more or less every day in our previous life up in the mountain. Especially for me, since I've been working with it. On the 5th of January, we left Las Palmas after a last call to the family back home, a steady breakfast and, of course, some last-minute preparation.
Hej!
Hej!
Tittar ni på film?
Vi har sett 3 minuter på er film. Mm. Så nu gör vi
paus. Det här är väl solen uppe?
Det är ingen europeisk så att det inte kostar
så mycket. Ja, nu kostar det ingenting.
Nej,
det ingår i abonnemanget.
Mm. Det är bra.
We filled the tanks with water from the pontoon, since we didn't want to use the water maker in the harbor. It was too much oil and dirt in the water that could clog the filter and the membrane. All the water in Las Palmas is desalinated and should be okay to drink. But to be on the safe side, we used pre-filters with phosphate to remove all the chalk and a 5-micron filter for small particles. We added hydrogen peroxide in the tank, and we have a coal filter close to the tap to make sure the water is drinkable. The only water bottles we have on board is in the grab bags if we have to abandon the ship. We filled up all the water and fuel tanks. The boat is probably 3 tons heavier with filled tanks, all the equipment and food compared to an empty boat.
Det är en liten prestigegrej att hissa först.
Ja,
nu är vi redan på andra plats.
Det är ju källor.
Åh. Vi har ju flera våningar.
Det är ju livsfarlig att öppna. Dör ju. Den är väldigt djup. Så där kan vi snacka om förvaring. Jag tror jag la den nederst.
Just det där lyftet med cyklar där man står så här.
Men hur går det för er?
Går det? Är vi då fan är det?
Är
det klar?
Då kanske är lite kaotisk. Jag tippar upp dig först. Okej, kom ut nu.
Men ska ni vänta på oss?
Vad mer då?
Alltså vänt på dock. Dock kommer ju som en rakett.
Men alltså jag måste ju filma när ni åker.
Hvis vi venter på dere nå, så skal vi vente på oss.
Jeg tror ikke så mange Najad har blitt
komma i samma mening som en raket.
Ja. Jag har inte. Ja.
Ska du hoppa nu eller? Du håll lite i handen. Du kan den vara borta nu. Vart är lite skummare.
Nej, Pål Lina. Ja.
Ja, han är på bryggan. Han passerar.
Du hade ju på den räddningsvästen. Kom då. Du kom bara av. Ja, nu går vi långt ifrån.
Ja, nu
har du Pål Lina igen eller? Nej, det är gammal du. Hej då.
Oh. Mina snuttisar.
Snutsigar.
Finisar.
Okej, okay,
men vi ses ju på Cape Verde en vecka utan Lina.
Ja, det låter.
Oj 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 oj. Det kan bli.
Nej.
Så.
Men du, vi ses inte på vägen.
Ja. Det blir bra.
Det blir bra.
Ja.
Hej då pappa.
Ja.
Då ses vi på Cape Verde, eller hur?
Ha det bra!
Ja, men detsamma!
Oh. Vi gläder oss åt att komma fram allerede för att träffa alla folk. Inte för att komma till land, men för att träffa folk igen.
Ta till! Ja, bara låt gå!
Ja, vi ska locka igen av här. Först ska vi där. Hör du?
Tack för att du sa det, din gamla karbonade. Som är en chokolade.
Slå dig du.
Ja, exakt. Hej då på er.
Hej då, ha det bra.
Vi ses i Mindalo.
Det gör vi. Om typ 7 dagar då.
Ja.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. See you in San Jose. Bye. Almost. It's just 4 boats left, I think. So we are in the ending. So we have to catch up the others.
Det var inte mycket vind.
We started in a gentle breeze, so we put up the Jennaker and looked forward to a smooth ride to Cape Verde. But only after a few hours, the wind picked up and the waves grew bigger. Gale winds between 25 to 35 knots with gusts above 40 knots for almost 5 days in a row. Luckily it was from the behind. The waves were approximately 3 meters, which is normally quite okay. It got extra rolly since the waves couldn't agree which way they were coming from. Most of the time they come from the back, but suddenly one decided to come from the side and splash down Svea and its crew. The interval of the waves were very short, so there were some steep waves that got up on deck on the back of the boat. We thought that we never would use our foul weather gear again, but we were wrong, big time. I made some resistance by using Lina's gear in the beginning, but eventually I had to use mine as well. Halfway across, the autopilot broke, so we had to hand steer for 3 days. Usually we had 3 to 4 hour shift with some flexibility depending on the state of each person. Now we had to change to strict 2 hour shift. It worked well, but it got a bit boring because it was not much time for anything else but steer, sleep and eat. Best feeling when you see or hear dolphin and suddenly realize there are 30 or more dolphins around the boat. And all the fly fish we saw made us very happy. We sailed past a turtle and another boat in the fleet saw a group of whales. Cooking in this condition is a challenge. We had 2 hot meals per day. Most of them were prepared before we left Las Palmas. In the middle of the night, 5.5 days after we left Las Palmas, we arrived in Mindelo in Cape Verde. We were surprised how well we felt when we got ashore. We had some sore muscles after all the hand steering, but we didn't feel very tired. The biggest issue was to walk straight when we got on land. The rolling inside our heads didn't stop even after a couple of days after we had tied up to the pontoon. Except for the autopilot, nothing broke, and we feel very safe and secure with the boat now. In the Viking Explorer group, all boats except one made it to Mindelo. Most of the crew thought it was tougher than expected. There were some broken parts with water in the engine, a generator failure and some rudder issues as the biggest problems. The boat that had to return ran aground just a few hours after the start and decided to go back to check out the boat. Lina, I and John liked the experience of being out for such a long time on the ocean. Being so close to the nature and so isolated made a strong impact on us. In next episode, you will get the full tour of Svea, so stay tuned. And help your grandpa to get a Google account so he can interact by writing comments and easier follow us by subscribing.